Well, guys, Middle Age Gamer, we're playing Train Simulator 2016, and we're live streaming at twitch.tv/themiddleagegamer. And again, we're playing the South Wales Coastal Route, and we're going to do something a little different today. We're actually going to do a freight route using the Class 70 Freightliner. And this is going to be career scenario number 5. Was it Wentlog to Southampton, or Wentlog to Southampton? About 50 minutes long, medium difficulty. And basically it says, step into the cab of this Class 70 Freightliner service to Southampton MCT from Wentlog Sightings. You'll be running a low priority, so when your signal has cleared, you may proceed. Shout out to Rainbirds for getting 1,000 of 1,000. Hopefully we can do the same. All right, Sam, I'll see you in a bit. And what up, Need for Speed? How's it going, man? Welcome back. I'm still happy that I fixed all my streaming problems. I haven't had one video lock up since yesterday. Very happy about that. What you been up to, Need for Speed? I know, I think you were on last night, weren't you? All right, here we go. Welcome aboard the 4051 or 4051. I don't know what that is. Freightliner Container Service to Southampton. Loading of the train is complete and you're ready to depart. The train is booked on a 10 a.m. path. Set the train up and get going when ready. Which means in train simulator fashion, get going immediately. This all looks pretty set up in here already. Let's take a look at our train. Oh, there we go. It's actually fairly long for a European freight. Kind of cool looking too, I like the big front window. Take a look at the back. There we go, just box containers all the way. Not too shabby at all. I like this cab, the cab's pretty insane looking in my opinion. Very interesting. Problem, we don't have permission to pass. Glad I checked. Jesus. That's cool. We'll just wait. You know, whatever. Hopefully they're not waiting here for another 4 minutes. It said 10 a.m. departure. That would really suck. Still denied. Oh well. Guess we're waiting for our high-speed train to pass. Pretty foggy outside. Yeah, I like this locomotive too. Never thought I'd like green and yellow, but it's definitely not bad. I see a train in the distance somewhere down there too. Oh, St. Pancras. That's where I got on in London. To go to Paris. They probably said it's too late. Don't worry about it. Step by step, this becomes a YouTube video. People can actually hear the second half of your story, hopefully. Hopefully we're not waiting on that bastard to go. He's going pretty slow. Another cargo. It's like hoppers right there or something. That's awesome. The ticket barriers are open. There you go. You could technically always hop them, but I would never do that. I like paying for things personally. Hoping we're not following this guy, because he is not going very fast at all. Let's look at the task list here. So we're going to be actually going under the tunnel. Crazy. There's a high-speed train right there. I don't think that's the one we're waiting on, though. I think they were serious about the 10 a.m. departure. So where were you going? Where'd you take the train from to London? Step by step. That's awesome. Yeah, I'll take the free ride any day too. All right, we got a yellow light. Let's go ahead and pull forward. I have no clue how many notches this thing has. Still love the big window. I would love to drive this train. Probably more so than the American counterpart with the long nose. Let's watch the train come out of the station too as well. Or out of the siding, I should say. And we're going to switch to the inner track. We are. Kind of figured that one. Get up to 20 miles per hour here. Double yellow, not too worried about that. Should be okay either way. Yeah, I didn't see the first part of the story, step by step. Part one, wanted to get to London. I got cleared to get up to 60 now. Oh, I get what you're saying. So you got to get on the Havilland at that point. Javelin, whatever it's called. West Canterbury. Sounds like a good day of traveling, honestly. A lot of mayhem. That's how I feel when I get in countries where I can't read the signs. I'm like, fuck it, let's just go. In fact, the funny part in Vancouver, just to kind of be on the lines with that, is the ticket machine. I tried to buy tickets like three times in a row and it kept taking my money and not giving a ticket. One of the locals, some lady came up and she's like, man, I take this every day without buying a ticket. They never check. Ticket to Vancouver where we were at. I was like, all right, well, I mean, I've already spent $20 on the machine. I could call it in and wait there, or I could just hop on the street rail there, whatever it's called. And yeah, there ain't no one checking tickets there. They could care less. Maybe in Seattle that would have the street rail. It was actually Seattle, excuse me, not Vancouver. Get some train buys for you guys so you're not stuck in the cab. Get some exterior views going. Definitely running full speed notch 8. Basically 100% power. Looks like we're actually running a little bit ahead of schedule too, which is good. Better be early than late. Canterbury to London's an hour long. It's not too bad. You said it's not a part of the London Faversham route, but they still have a Havilland or Javelin on there. Is it a one route train? Really? Is Canterbury part of the London Faversham route though? So I'm confused now. Wasn't a Freightliner empty one going back? Let's go get back in cab since we're getting close to the 6 mile per hour speed limit. Yeah, they're pretty strict on tickets. In fact, they're really strict on tickets in England. If you look at how clean they keep those stations, it's pretty insane. I remember a couple of times in London, I'd see a sticker one night. Very next morning, I'd get on the train to go somewhere on one of the circle lines, whatever you want to call it. And sure enough, that sticker would be completely gone by the next morning. I'm like, damn, that's crazy as hell. All right, we're definitely getting close to a train in front of us. Go ahead and do some light braking since we're way ahead of schedule, just in case we have to really slow down. It's not good. We got a single. There's the double yellow I was looking for. I was like, oof. I'm gonna run it at about 40 miles per hour now. Slow down too much. What up, Dean? What's going on, man? I really want to read chat, but I also want to pay attention so I don't jack this route up. People are hit with fines left and right. Leave that. Is that double yellow? I'm okay with double yellow, so I'll do that all day long. Canterbury is beyond Faversham, but it's still serviced by Javelins. Is Canterbury in the route on Train Simulator? Or is it actually beyond where you can stop at in the game? You've received fines for having the wrong ticket or improper ticket when riding a train in London. Not long finished streaming this route. Not sure if I'm reading that right by chance. Following some yellows. Let's see where we're going. Still got about 11 miles before the Severn Tunnel. What up, Test Flight? Where'd you get hired at, man? Awesome, congratulations as well. Oh, I get what you're saying, Dean. Yeah. we're down to a single yellow, which makes me very nervous. Oh, we got danger approved to pass, though. That just makes me confused. Unless we're going to pass the other train up for some reason. See, my ETA is actually still going down. Alright, it says I can pass this red light. I'm a little nervous about it. Thinking it's a bad idea myself, but not sure. I don't think this is the Severn Tunnel, is it? Still says I can pass. Let me idle through this just in case. See what happens. Oh, Sports Authority? Nice. I don't think they have Sports Authority down in Texas anymore. It's just Academy and Dick's Sporting Goods, but I've been to a Sports Authority before, I know that. It's not in the London Faversham route. All right. Now we got a green light suddenly. Maybe the other Class 70 pulled off to the side to let us go by here at the new port up. My assumption, but we'll see here in just a minute. Afraid to get out of the cab until we get into more clear part of the line. All right, at least we're on time. That's good. Screeching some tracks right now. Yeah, if they did an extension to London or Faversham, I would play that all day long. That's definitely my number one or two routes. It's between that and London to Peterborough. And this is honestly at the top of the list right now, too. The South Wales Coastal is pretty awesome. If I could go back, I would only buy those routes and get rid of all the other crap that I have. That's completely junk, in my opinion. There you go, test flight. Nothing wrong with 370. I think I'm good for a couple train buys now. I think I'm in the clear, hopefully. Still got about 9.5 miles to go to the tunnel from Wales to England. Got to blast that scenario in that car. You're talking about the one that I did like a 700 in yesterday? Or do you mean test flight? Anyways, appreciate everybody for watching on the live stream. Shout out to everybody on YouTube. If I make it 1,000 of 1,000, you'll be seeing this on YouTube as well. Haven't done a European freight route in a long, long time, so I think this would be good for you too. I I don't plan on saving it either, which could definitely bite me in the ass if I mess up. Scream a Rob to the music. Yeah, the only reason I'm not blasting music right now, just so you guys know, is because I'm not planning to put this on YouTube. So after this, I'll play some music as long as I don't call it a day. Got a lot of stuff to do as far as work goes, unfortunately. Might be a while, Big Vinny. They always, even when they have like the big summer and winter sales and all that, if it's a brand new route, they're never gonna have it on sale. I was wanting to get I don't know if it was Canadian Mountain Pass or whatever it was. The only routes that I wanted to get were not on sale during the last team sale. Definitely do. This is it's very true to the England and Wales area. Nice and drizzly, foggy, downright miserable. I love rainy weather. A lot of people hate it though. Good looking locomotive, in my opinion. Still like it. See the whole train go by real fast. Definitely not as long as American freight, but by European standards, it's pretty good size. Test flight YouTube and the copyrights. Exactly why I'm not jamming music, unfortunately. It was a sad day when they came out with that. Especially all the music trolls out there that will try to claim something that's not theirs. I still get copyright claims for stuff that doesn't even have music on it. I'm like, dude, this Chinese person did not claim any of my video that I made by my goddamn self. Even the developers themselves for Train Simulator gave me permission to post this on YouTube and monetize this as well. Oh well. What up, Lord? How's it going? Lord BT? I didn't talk to you for an hour. Oh, you should have saw San Antonio a couple nights ago. Man, we got hit with a huge hailstorm. 300 BMWs, every single BMW at the BMW lot in San Antonio has damage. Broken windows, dents everywhere. All the customer cars that were there for service all got messed up, broken windows. I'm like, man, that's brutal. Ooh, I want to speed. Getting really nervous about speeding now. Okay. Pretty sure we're on level ground right now. I don't know why I'm picking up speed. About 6 miles to go to the tunnel, which again is a pretty crucial part of this particular route as well. I've never heard anybody say they missed the British weather step by step. That's all right, Lord. It's like, man, I'm here. I would talk to you, man. Promise I'm not that much of an asshole. Definitely one of the longer routes I've done on this particular Southwest or South Coastal Wales, South Wales Coastal. Can't even talk, I've been drinking. I've actually looked at the Google Maps at St. Pancras. Never really thought about that. Connect the London Faversham to London Peterborough. They could probably do it. I'm surprised moderators or mods haven't done it yet. They've connected a lot of parts or different routes in London together already on the Steam Workshop. Be heading towards the tunnel now. Do a couple train bys for you guys. I love the rain. Unfortunately, being in Texas, we don't get a whole lot of it, so I really got to enjoy it. My girlfriend loves dancing in the rain. Haven't got that far yet. But I'm used to the 100 plus degree days and high humidity, unfortunately. Living here in San Antonio. But you get used to it. I even wear long sleeves for work, and I'm used to the heat. Looks like we're going over a little bridge right here. I got to end up braking on the other side here in just a moment. There we go. And roughly about 3.5 miles to go to the tunnel. Again, pretty neat part of this particular journey. I guess it was the longest tunnel in the UK for many, many years until the London Faversham route came out. Someone told me the statistics last night as far as the years go. I'm guessing London to Faversham was in 2007, but this tunnel was built way back in the day. Probably why there's not lights inside the tunnel like the London Faversham route. Faversham, whatever you want to say it. St. Pancras to King's Cross? I'm not 100% sure on that. My assumption is they could. How they would do it, I don't know. I heard California is going through a really, really bad drought. Is that still the case, guys? I know San Antonio, we're getting rain every single day this week for like, I don't even know, the next 7-10 days. There's a connection between the lines. There you go, Need for Speed. Someone's got Google Maps out looking at it. Shout out to all my viewers as well watching here on the live stream. If you're not talking already in chat, make sure to say what's up YouTube, because hopefully this will be going on YouTube at some point in the near future. There you go. 1873 is when this tunnel that we're about to go through was built. Just process that for a minute. 1873. That's some crazy engineering back in the day. And we're about to go through it in about 2 miles. Task list. We still got about 13 miles to go in total. It's going to be one long tunnel that we're going under, too. Supposedly, we could speed up to about 70 miles per hour, which max speed is 75 on this locomotive. Green lights, which is good. Do one final train by if I can get it. There we go. This will be our last train by for a minute while we go through the tunnel. Cleared up to 70, and we're gonna get back in cab for this tunnel coming up in a mile. Oddly enough, we can go max speed through it. I think it's 75 coming up. Go ahead and save it just in case something happens. I feel really bad about going this fast. Go ahead and blow my horn going by this platform just in case. To the tunnel here in just a minute. We'll definitely start picking up speed going downhill here as well. So I have to be careful about that, knowing the weight of the train. Wrong time, that's positive. Alright, get ready for some darkness, guys. It's gonna be a long tunnel. What up, San? About to go through the Severn Tunnel, built in, was it 1873? It was the longest tunnel until the London to Faversham Tunnel was built, I think in 2007-ish, somewhere in that area. We're definitely hauling above 60 miles an hour now, trying to get our way up to 75. Way ahead of schedule. Go ahead and let it idle. We should be still picking up speed as we go down. I don't know, Sant. I'm probably going to call it a night after this. I'm going to do a really, really long stream for 420 tomorrow, along with giving away a bunch of free games. And it's also going to be my 7K subscriber special. I'm right at 7,000 subscribers on YouTube, so I'm pretty proud about that. So tomorrow is definitely going to be the day that I'll be doing a lot of Train Simulator and possibly another game like World of Subways or something similar to that. We'll see what happens.
a good question.
I think I've been on the 395 in England. Pretty sure I have. There's those blue lights that I saw yesterday when I was in the passenger view going through the tunnel. Should be another blue light coming up. I think it signals the end of the decline, the start of the incline. That'd be my guess, at least. Blazing. Hell yeah, test flight. That's exactly what I'll be doing. Awesome, Need for Speed. I'll see you tomorrow then, man. Sand, it'll probably be starting around 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. You know who's missing in here? Wayne Taylor said he was going to stop by today. I'm kind of disappointed he's not in here. He even said he's going to pick up some beer to hang out and watch me stream some trains him tonight. Surprised he's not on here. The Flying Scotsman's back in service, really? It's kind of crazy. Alright, so it looks like we're stopping in about 7 miles at the Bristol Parkway up. Passenger loop. We're cleared for 90, even though max speed up here does say, I can't even see with the cab light on. It says 75 up there in the top right. Way ahead of schedule, about 6 minutes. Yeah, you need, if you're gonna stock up on beer at any point, it's definitely gonna be for tomorrow's stream. Especially if there's only, what, you know, 6 to 10 people watching, everybody's gonna be getting a free game tomorrow at some point. I think I'll make a rule where if you already won a game, you can't win another game. You can still guess to keep it going and restart the counter for a 0 to 100 guessing game. But I want as many people to get a free game tomorrow as possible is my plan. I think the big boy is sitting in a museum, never to be turned on. Definitely lost a lot of speed. I know, Sand, if there's only, like I said, what, we got 10 people in here right now, I'll definitely be giving away probably 10 games, because it's a 7K special, which I haven't done one in a long time. It's 4:20, and it's Wednesday night when I typically do my lengthy stream, so tomorrow's going to be the day for you guys. Ooh, nice. Lord said the big boy will be up and running by summer 2017 by Union Pacific. That'd be cool to see. I don't know, Sam. I'll show you the games after this route to show you what I have in my inventory that could potentially be given out. We'll see. There'll be some pretty good stuff in there, though. I'm going to go ahead and save this one more time. Since we're right at 5 miles to go to the final station, just want to make sure I don't mess this up. I'm going to do a couple train buys for you guys. No, American Truck Sim will not be up for grabs tomorrow. I don't think I have that in my inventory, but I'll check before I say that. That'll be one thing I'll do before I end the stream. show you what games I have. And I'll try to start the stream off as early as possible tomorrow. I may even start around 5:30 Central Standard Time if I can. That way, by the time we get to 7, 8 o'clock, we have some viewers in here that can win some games. Ooh. It's like taking straight shots right there. You really need ATS. I love that game. I'm still waiting for Arizona to come out, though. You can see the movement. Pretty cool view, in my opinion. Yeah, they definitely need more truck licenses. They said it's pretty hard to get them compared to getting car licenses, because the car manufacturers are so used to having their cars licensed for racing games like Gran Turismo and Project Cars, but it's just not a big thing in the semi-truck world. At least not yet. Hopefully it is one day. I agree, Need for Speed is pretty boring. I only seen the two classes. I really want to see the Volvo put in there. Some different models of the Peterbilts and Kenworths would be nice. What else do they got? What's another big semi-truck builder? There you go, yeah. ETS 2 West France. I heard they're making new junctions and stuff for France, so that should be pretty cool. Add a little bit more dynamic to that. I need to start playing Euro Truck Simulator multiplayer. I think the only people who are still playing are like legit people who love that game and driving, whereas American Truck still has a bunch of jackasses in it. Oh, there you go. Yeah, Freightliner International. I don't think I've seen Western Star Trucks. That doesn't ring a bell to me. My whiskey right there. I'm gonna try to keep it 100% green and healthy tomorrow. Water, salad, and Colorado. Mack trucks, that's not really, do they have semi trucks though? I've seen like a lot of Mack dump trucks and stuff like that. Do they actually make like the big semi haulers? And I do have a question for you guys, you may not know it. In North America, do they have, or I should say the U.S., do they have any flat-fronted semi-trucks like they do in Europe? You know, most of the trucks here have the huge front noses. I want to know if they have the cab-over-engine trucks here in the U.S. or not. I was always curious about that. All right, so I got about 1.7 miles to go. Again, we're way ahead of schedule, probably about 5 minutes or so. So Mack has a semi, or used to, alright. What about the cab over engines? I'm surprised, because you'd think they would have better gas mileage and better fuel efficiency. Got plenty of time. I'm just going to kind of idle. See, we should be stopping up here though at some point. All right, AWS system going off. Go ahead and correct that. Kenworth and Freightliner made them. Cab over engine's really nice. Yeah, I've seen the box trucks with the cab over engines. I'm talking about the heavy haulers, though. I'm surprised they don't have more of them here in the U.S. It just seems a little strange, you know? I wonder what the reasoning is. I guess in North America, they have plenty of room on the roads where they really don't need the cab over engine. The Bristol Parkway up passenger loop. About to stop here in just a second. Looks like a pair of HSTs up ahead. Assuming we're heading left to the side track. These guys are probably pissed off I'm on the track. Sorry, guys. Just running freight, they'll be mad at me. Need for Speed, yeah, if Test Flight can give you the permission to go ahead and post a link. We'll be able to check it out here in a little bit too. Alright, my back end's past that last signal so the HSTs can leave. I'll stop up here in just a little bit. Should be cleared to go ahead and stop now. There we go. Yeah, it's been a long time since I've done any freight routes. Really enjoyed that one though. In fact, I enjoyed this entire route. South Wales Coastal, not bad by any means. There you go. So we're held here until the signal clears. And that's going to be another 1,000 of 1,000. We got the South Wales Coastal 4051 score achievement right there. Very nice. I don't think any friends have actually beat this route as of yet from what it's saying. Shout out to everybody on the global list that's beat this for 1,000 of 1,000. Using the Class 70 Freightliner right there. Anyways, again, tomorrow's going to be the special 420 stream, giving away a bunch of free games, and I'm going to call it the 7K subscriber special for YouTube as well, since that's really what it's all about, is my YouTube channel. This video will be going on YouTube, so hopefully you guys will see yourself talking on there. You can check that out here in the next day or two, and I appreciate all you guys for watching. Shout out to Sand, who hasn't been on here before. He was on here earlier with Step by Step talking to me for a while, and shout out to everybody else, Need for Speed, Lord, Test Flight, etc., etc. Anyways, Middle Age Gamer, I'll see you guys tomorrow, hopefully, and take care. Later.